This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the planet Jupiter. I provided this texture map of Jupiter's surface so you could follow along. Its link is in my video's description or project files. Before we begin, if you want to know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, smash that subscribe button, and please remember to click that like button, which lets YouTube know you like my stuff. The first step is to convert this texture into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel, and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Distort, and Sphereize. Make the amount 100%. Open your Elliptical Marquee tool and feather it 2 pixels. Place your cursor a bit inside a corner of the image and press and hold the Shift key as you drag a circular selection to a bit inside the opposite corner. Then release. Holding Shift kept the selection a perfect circle. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. Layer masks are basically stencils. White areas reveal the image next to it, while black areas conceal the image. Then convert your visible image into a smart object. We'll create a background that will place our planet over. To do this, go to File and New. Make the width 1920 pixels, the height 1080 pixels, and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. If the background color box isn't black, click it, and when the color picker opens, pick black. Then click Create or Open. Convert it into a smart object and go to Filter, Noise, and Add Noise. Make the amount 100%, Gaussian, and monochromatic. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 0.5 pixels. Press Ctrl or Command L to open Levels. Make the input shadows 180, and the input highlights 220. Name the layer Stars. To save some space in the Layers panel, let's collapse the smart filters. Make a new layer below it by Ctrl or Command clicking the New Layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with black, but before we do, check your foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since black is our foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill our empty layer with the foreground color. Temporarily hide the stars layer and open back the Jupiter texture map that you spherized. Press V to open the Move tool and drag the planet onto the black background tab. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. We'll rotate it by pressing Ctrl or Command T to open our transform tool. Go to a corner, and when you see a curved double arrow, rotate it counterclockwise to an angle you like. To reposition it, go inside the Transform's bounding box and drag it. Then press Enter or Return. Double-click an empty area of the planet layer to open its layer style window. Click Outer Glow. If the color box isn't white, click it and pick white. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 100%, and the noise is 0%. The technique is softer, the spread is 0, and the size is 90 pixels. The contour is linear, and the range is 100%. Click the New Layer icon and name it Highlight. Open your Brush tool and invert your colors by pressing X on your keyboard so white is your foreground color. Open the brush picker and pick a soft, round brush. Make the size 1000 pixels and the hardness 0%. The opacity and flow are both 100% each. place your cursor approximately here and click once. To confine the highlight to the inside of the planet, Control or Command click the thumbnail of the planet to select its shape. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. Make the highlight active and reduce its opacity to 80%. Next, we'll place our planet in shadow. Make a new layer and Control or Command click the layer mask to select its shape. Go to Select and Transform Selection. Make sure the chain link icon is active between the transform's width and height. Go to either field and type in 150%. Drag the selection over and up to approximately here. Then press Enter or Return or click the check mark at the top. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 100 pixels. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-I. We'll fill the selection with black, and since our background color is black, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. We'll make the black stronger by filling it with black again. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command-D. Change its blend mode to Soft Light. Open your Move tool and drag it to the right approximately this much. We'll group the two shadow layers into a folder by shift-clicking the bottom shadow to make it active as well, and pressing Ctrl or Command-G. Name it Shadow. Make the stars layer visible and active. Make a selection of the planet's shape, and Alt or Option-click the layer mask icon to make an inverted layer mask of the selection. Open your Brush tool and Brush Picker. Make its size 150 pixels. Place your brush inside your planet approximately here and slowly arc your brush up and over as you brush over its edge. End it by swinging your brush up to inside the planet. Lastly, we'll add a distant sun. Create a new layer and name it Sun. Fill it with black and change its blend mode to screen. Convert it into a smart object. Go to Filter, Render, and Lens Flare. The brightness is 100% and the lens type is 105 mm prime. Drag the lens flare near the upper right corner. I want to mask out the secondary lens flares at the lower right. If you want to do this as well, make the lens flare layer mask active, and with your brush tool active, increase its size, and brush over that area to mask them out. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.